for pain occurring in the hand and wrist. It's not related to trauma, meaning no fall or impact injury. We're talking mostly a difference and excluding tendonitis. We have that in a different talk, speech, or whatever. In any case, we differentiate pain in the hand and wrist. We're differentiating arthritis from something like carpal tunnel syndrome. There's really pretty big difference. Where there's a little bit of confusion is on the base of the thumb, because people with arthritis at the base of the thumb, if they have symptoms, may hurt all through this area. But generally speaking, pain in the fleshy muscle there, called the abductor pollicis, it's caused by carpal tunnel syndrome from pinched nerve. Pain at the down in this area is usually arthritis at the trapezio metacarpal joint, the base of the thumb. And it's not really well shown up here in this diagram. But in any case, that's very localized. It turns out that a person who has arthritis at the base of their thumb has about a 50% chance of having carpal tunnel syndrome. So when we end up doing surgery on the person for the arthritis, we usually need to do a carpal tunnel release at the same time. But the big difference in the symptoms in general are arthritis causes pain and stiffness. Carpal tunnel syndrome usually doesn't result in pain. As a matter of fact, that throws most doctors. Some of people have pain, and if they have pain, it's at nighttime. The main symptoms of carpal tunnel syndrome are numbness, tingling, and loss of dexterity or feeling of clumsiness, difficulty picking up small things, things falling out of first hand. Every time you pick up your pen, it's on the floor. Picking up paper clips, needles, that sort of thing become difficult. And so the big difference, one's more of a functional thing versus just a complaint of pain.